So, hello everyone. Welcome here at Bertrand, our assembly partner in Munich. Usually you don't get beyond this point in regular mature OEMs. They don't want to show you the assembly workshop, but we want to take you here. We want to show you what's going on. Since we are a transparent company, let me give you some insight. Over here we have the warehouse. You have been seeing in an earlier video, many parts have been arriving there, several thousands, enough for building up several serious validation vehicles. Over here we see the assembly facilities, two cars in assembly process. We will take a look together, and here we see some pre-assembly stations. And the first thing I would like to show you today are some interior parts, just to give you an idea about inner door trim parts, two options. Yeah, we will assemble both to see how is it looking, how does it feel, to get some more ideas. We have many more parts, but yeah, too many to show you today. Also, we have some screens here. We will later assemble into the car and get functioning. Here we have, for example, our famous MOS, can still be touched, not covered yet. And we have the upper cover of the instrument panel. This will be assembled quite late because we need to work here underneath for a while. Here we can see something more, the MOS already covered and with a nice frame. Also, we can see the B pillar cover, the upper one, will be assembled later. First, some work needs to go on underneath. Same for the A pillar cover, which is this one. Then we can see some other pre-assembly about the closures. Please follow me. Here we have one of the rear doors in pre-assembly process, already with the glass inside, window lifter, speaker. We have the solar body panel, which we can see from underneath. Later it's covered here. And this door, of course, needs to go to one of the target vehicles. Here we have the same, just the other side. We see the solar body panel much better than in our predecessor vehicle. Really, really good, like it's coming out. Right, so those are a few little insights so far. Parts are coming now to reality. They are coming out of the computer. For our engineers, a very, very important, yeah, and also emotional step. Imagine you're working for a month on something, you're detailing it, and now, yeah, you can see it's working. And later when it gets into the market, yeah, you have achieved something and you have created something that stays. Yeah, you developed it, so that must be highly motivating. And yeah, maybe we can even say one of the best jobs in the world, being an engineer. Let's come to this vehicle. This is the second vehicle we received here in Munich. This is going to be a market and marketing vehicle. This is the body in white, aluminum space frame design. Here we see the electric drive unit, completely carry over from Vitesco. Engine mount, compressor, some parts of HVAC, cooling and thermal system. Here we see the front right suspension, which is designed according to McPherson principle, which is very, yeah, a very mature and reliable design principle we chose here. And if we take a look here inside, we can see steering system. Let's go on maybe here to the rear side of the vehicle. Here we can see the rear axle already completely installed. Basically just tires missing and some parts here. Okay, let's maybe continue with the first vehicle we received here in Munich. This is going to be our functional integration vehicle to really, yeah, work on reliability of all the electric functions. But before we come to that, let's take a look. What else can we see here? For example, the front fender is already assembled, also with the solar body panels in really good quality. Tires already installed, so this is much more advanced already. Even here on the roof, we have the solar body panels installed. And with this vehicle, usually this is covered to protect it from scratches, but we want to show this to you, so this is why we opened it today. Later we will protect it again. But besides this, Luke will explain you a few things about something else, and that's also very, very interesting, I can promise for you. So, Luke.
Thanks, Markus. So my responsibility within Sono Motors is kind of electrical department as a whole. So within this department, there are several teams, but today we will concentrate a minute on the EDS team. So that's electrical distribution system. So the electrical distribution system, which you can see all over the front end of the vehicle and interior of the vehicle, is not just a wire and harness. You have to think of it more of as the physical electrical architecture of the vehicle. So what does this mean? You can think of it like a central nervous system of the body. It's all power, control and communication with all the ECUs and components within the vehicle. So this particular vehicle will be used as an electrical testing vehicle. So we'll be verifying all our CAE results on this vehicle. We'll also be verifying our assembly instructions and kind of installation, let's say. So at the moment you can see that the brake controller is installed and we're kind of trialing each component one at a time at the moment to see how the actual module itself fits, the bracket, the EDS, and how it all goes together. Same thing here with the AC compressor. Let's take a little look at the inside of the vehicle now, and I'll show you some more. So the interior of the vehicle, the main harness runs through the IP, or the cross cab beam, let's say in this instance, so this metal piece. This will be eventually built up to be a singular IP and will be installed in the vehicle in one unit, let's say, including all of the electronic control units. So we have like emergency call unit, vehicle control module, hazard light switches, fuse boxes, HVAC controller, power steering, everything integrated in one and installed in one unit. You can also see that the harness is kind of integrated into the sills. This is to support kind of the door functions, seatbelt functions, and also rear the vehicle functions, such as the rear axle, for example. You'll also see that the harness runs up the A pillars for the roof harness, which is largely for PV label or solar cell technology, let's say, but then also for the airbags and the overhead center console units. This particular vehicle has 1400 wires in it, which is about 2.4 kilometers of total length of wire. But before we install this into this vehicle, we test it on the test board. So let's go to the test board. So this is our test board setup for SVC3. What you can see here is all the ECUs installed on one test board with the complete wire harness laid out onto the board. So we do this to both commission the wire harness per vehicle set, but also to do functional tests on each control module. So we have the battery management system here, the charging unit here, the electrical drive unit here, electric heater, for example, and AC compressor, among other ECUs. So now I'll hand you over to Arbor just to show some kind of level of functional tests that we do here on this board.
All right, thanks a lot, Luke, for handing over. So as Luke already mentioned, these setups allow us to flash, program different ECUs to see their interaction. For example, we have powertrain ECUs, we have chassis components, we have body electronic components such as exterior lights, window regulators, door latches for locking and unlocking the vehicle. So all of these components, for the first time, they come together in this setup, and this is the first time we can check all of them and their interaction. One of the main tests that we do once the modules are connected and are powered up, we trigger the wake up, so they are awake, and we can see if they are communicating with the rest of the vehicle and if they are communicating between each other. We use state-of-the-art software and tools for that. For example, here we have the CAN communication for the three CAN buses, and we can see all the ECUs in the vehicle are awake. We can see the electronic stability control ECU, we can see the electric power steering, but this is only one part of the tests. As Luke mentioned, we do also functional tests. For example, I can unlock the vehicle when we are missing a specific ECU. I can simulate the behavior of that ECU. Just give me a second. So right now I just unlocked the vehicle and we can see the light animation going on and we can hear the latches clicking. And once the vehicle is unlocked, then we can turn on, for example, the day running light. We can turn on the low beam. We can turn on the high beam. We can have the flash beam all the time. Turn indicators left, turn indicator right. We can turn on also the hazard light switch, for instance. And we can check if the turn indicators are in the front exterior lights, on the side mirror, and in the rear lights. We can also check, for example, some features like at the front wiper motor, in this case, with different speeds. So, for example, this is the first speed. And then we have even faster speed. We can check the washer pump and so on. For example, we can check if the vehicle, in case we unlock the vehicle, if the Ajar is working, so is it going to be shown to the user? Right now, the instrument cluster, it's not connected, but if you see here, nothing is latched already. And when it's red, it means that the Ajar, so the door is locked. And once I'm going to unlock it, the color should change. So we see a color change, meaning that the BCM, or the body control module, which is responsible for this feature, is properly recognizing that the Ajar, that the door is opened, and it's transmitting to the rest of the vehicle. These are only a scratch on the surface of all the tests that we do here. There are a lot of functional safety tests, the diagnostics tests, and so on. But you can leave this for another day. So, Markus, hand over to you again.
Okay, thank you, Luke. Thank you, Abba. What have we seen now so far? We have been seeing the wiring harness on the yellow board. We have been seeing how it's integrated into the target vehicle. We have seen another vehicle, some pre-assembly steps. But let's zoom out a little. What are we doing here? It's not just assembling parts. It is about creating a mature and reliable vehicle. We have some parts that come carry over. They are mature for themselves. We don't need to focus so much on the system level on those parts and systems, but we develop a lot on our own. And this really needs to become more and more mature, more and more, more reliable, and then finally completely validated before we bring it to you, to the customers, to the market. So this is happening here step by step. And we hope that we could give you this insight today. We are looking forward to give you some more insights. So the job is not done. We are still on the way, but we are on a very good way. And we will probably provide some focus information, for example, on interior closures and maybe the high voltage system. We have not been talking about that for a while. So that's all from our side for today. Thanks and goodbye. you.